And forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory
forever. Okay, for those that are standing, there are still lots of chairs, so come find a seat. And it's okay if you're wearing a t-shirt, you can sit down. There's chairs available. And all of our guests. Okay, and I take back everything I said about amateurs. That was wonderful. I didn't know we had a professional amongst us. Okay, we will now be favored with Hiram Egbert, who's one of the grandsons, who's going to share a story about Grandpa Evans. When he was young and living in Salt Lake City, he had a favorite toy, and that was his little red wagon. And so Hiram is going to come up and tell us a story about Grandpa Evans.
Okay. As you all know, my grandpa is a really good man, and he always helps me to do what is right. One day I asked Grandpa, "Did you ever tell a lie?" Now Grandpa, who was always honest, told me the truth. He said only once. Then he told me that he quickly repented and has always told the truth since then. This is how it happened. Grandpa was about 7 years old. He was the youngest in his family, and sometimes he was bored when his sisters were gone, when his dad was at work, and his mom was always baking. So, on a day such as this, Grandpa, who was known as J. Fred, decided to play with his little red wagon. This was a special wagon, but wasn't much fun when he had to pull and wasn't able to ride it. What could he do that would be fun? Then he knew exactly what would be the best ride he had ever gone on his little red wagon. J. Fred lived in Salt Lake City in the Avenues part of town. There were hills to walk up and run down. So Grandpa, being bored one summer day, decided to pull his little red wagon up the hill. It was a long way to the top, and he was pretty tired when he got there. He looked down the hill and thought, if I rode down, it would be quicker than walking. So he put the little red wagon in the street and started down for the best ride he thought he would ever have. Oh, it was such fun. The breeze blew in his face, and the further we went down, the faster he went. But suddenly he was going too fast. The handle on the wagon started to shake. Then the wheels began to shake, and they wouldn't go straight anymore. Oh dear. What was Grandpa to do? He tried so hard to go straight forward, but he lost control, and soon he was going back and forth. While he tried to make the handle stay still and the wheels go straight. Oh no, there was a big bump, and he tried to miss it, but he still ran into it. Grandpa flew off the wagon into the street while the wagon ran into the curb and came finally to a stop. Poor Grandpa, his knees were bleeding and scraped, and his elbows were dripping blood. What would he do now? Knowing that he needed to go home, but not wanting to tell his mother that he had been riding his wagon in the street, he went into the house. Here he was, all bruised and bleeding. His mother asked, "J. Fred, what happened to you?" Grandpa just said, "Oh, I fell off the fence." That's the story.
Okay. Well, when Mom and Dad were married, they had a bicycle built for two, and you could often see them riding around the neighborhood on their way to the park. But after moving to Utah, shortly after moving to Utah, they were asked to speak in state conference. And wouldn't you know it, when they got to state conference and saw the program, for some strange reason, instead of Patsy Evans, it said Daisy Evans on the program. They don't know where that came from, but it was a big joke amongst all of their friends and between Mom and Dad. Well, now we'll be favored with the song A Bicycle Built for Two, and we didn't have to change the words to Daisy, Daisy. Okay, and this will actually be sung by all of the children and the husbands or wives of their children. The blue t-shirts. Get up here.
You get to stand in front.
Because on Mom and Dad's first date, Mom knew she was going to marry Dad. Dad didn't know it yet, but she knew. But it's funny because after four dates, then he didn't show up for another 2 weeks. And when he showed up, he had a bunch of papers that needed to be typed for his school. And so it's funny because she had been waiting for her dearie. And the next song will be Elizabeth singing Waiting for My Dearie.
Thank you. a man and a life. I hold a dream and there's no compromises. I know there's one certain lady for me. One day he'll come walking o'er the horizon. But should he not, then an old maid I'll be. Foolish ye may say, foolish I will stay, waiting for my dearie, and happy am I to hold my heart till he comes strolling by. When he comes, my dear.
When Dad finally did propose, and Mom said yes, and that's another story, by the way. You'll have to ask him about it sometime. Dad was, don't ask Dad. Dad was happy because he could go home with Patsy Ann. And now Mary, Elizabeth, Anna, and Celesta Dunlap will sing.